Welcome to the Tomb of the Unknown Warrior. Welcome to representatives of the Commonwealth War Graves Commission. We give thanks for all those who died in the wars and all those buried in the graves cared for by the Commonwealth War Graves Commission. And it's a pleasure to invite representatives of the Commission, those working in the cemeteries themselves, to lay a wreath here at the grave of the unknown warrior of flowers from their responsibility. And as we think of those many, many young men and women who have died in the conflicts of the last 100 years, united in spirit with this unknown warrior who lies here in state, and united in this moment through the wreath laid here, let us remember with thanksgiving all those whose names we know and those whose names we don't know, who gave up their lives that we might be free.
Well, this year marks the 90th anniversary of the Commonwealth War Graves Commission's founding, and it was wonderful to be able to reinstate an old tradition when four of our gardening staff, the men and women who are very much at the front line of what we do in remembering the dead, were able to come here to Westminster to lay a wreath that they'd made themselves from foliage of the cemeteries of the Western Front here at the Tomb of the Unknown Warrior. And not just as an anniversary event, but very much as a mark of respect to all of those men and women who rest in our perpetual care. And of course as a promise, as a challenge, that we would definitely carry on remembering them, not just for another 90 years, but in perpetuity.
There is always more and more visitors coming to the cemeteries, and the respect they show towards the graves make us feel the work very worthwhile to do. We do get a lot of feedback from the visitors, and after every grave there is a whole story, and people respect us for that, and we are very proud to do the work.
I work and for the War Graves Commission for 40 years, so I think it's nice to be there to present the War Graves Commission and the soldiers, the men and women who lost their life, and to remember them.
As a young boy, I grew up in the shadow of the Menin Gate in Ypres, and I was always very, very impressed by the sound of the last post. And now I'm very honored that I can join the Remembrance Day here in London this year. And I'm very impressed by all the crosses the people put down around the Westminster Abbey. So I'm very, very impressed by this.
We're very much looking back at 90 years of remembrance. And today, the Unknown Warrior has been a very potent symbol of the Commission and why we continue to remember the fallen. We have to remember that they gave everything for us, and to highlight that to my generation and to future generations. So we're very much now looking forward to the next 90 years and keeping our work relevant.
Who was the Unknown Warrior? A question we'll never be able to answer. But the idea is attributed to an army chaplain, a gentleman called the Reverend David Railton, who served on the Western Front during the First World War. And one evening when he was walking near his billet at Armentier, he came across a grave simply marked with a wooden cross with the words, "An unknown soldier of the Black Watch." And he wrote a letter to the Dean of Westminster, where we are today, and suggested that perhaps one unknown warrior would represent all of the countless millions who had lost in the war. The Dean thought it was a great idea, wrote to the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister wrote to the King. And pretty quickly, the wheels were set in motion to repatriate an unknown warrior. The coffin was laid in a newly dug tomb where nobody had ever been buried before. And the unknown soldier himself rests on earth brought from France and Belgium, so that he will always lie on the earth of the land which he defended with his life. The four gardeners today are representative of the gardeners the Commission employs all over the world, who work on a daily basis in the cemeteries and memorials, making sure that we don't forget these men and women. And I have enormous respect for them, because they work in all weathers and all conditions to bring such comfort to millions and millions of people all over the Commonwealth. Bill, for example, has worked officially for the War Graves Commission for some 40 years, but he still remembers working as a five-year-old with his dad in the war cemetery, weeding the border. So unofficially, more than half a century of devotion to the work that the War Graves Commission does.
And a prayer of blessing, finally. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all mankind, peace and concord. And to us and all sinners, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.